So I want to thank you all for subscribing to my channel. You guys are totally amazing. And for those of you who are new to my channel, well, feel free to subscribe because I am always testing and checking out the best products, the best toys, the best games to make education fun. And I know you and your kids don't want to miss it. So feel free to subscribe. Now, before I actually get to the review, today I'm going to show you this. It's really this box. It's a whole program more than product. But this is Note Perfect and it's from noteperfectproject.com. And I think this is going to be amazing. But before I actually open the box and show you what's in it and how I'll be using it for education, I want to give you a little bit of history. Now, many years ago, when I was in high school, I had a very short opportunity to take music lessons. And now, I didn't really get to pick the instrument, but one thing led to another. My friend was selling her flute. I bought it. I found a teacher that was affordable, and before you knew it, I took for a very brief time flute lessons. Now, I stopped when college got in the way. I picked it up again, start, stop, start, stop. You know how the cycle works. But every time I started, I kind of pushed myself to the next level without a teacher. And, you know, I'm not the best flute player, but I can act, I know how to read sheet music, I know how to have fun, I know how to play, you know, my favorite songs, and one thing led to the next, and before I know it, this year, I am going to teach the flute to a group of students. Now, I'm really excited, but of course, I love playing music, and it really brings out, you know, a part of me that I never knew could, you know, existed. And I wanted to make it fun for my students. Now, I did have music lessons with a traditional teacher, and that was okay. And I really have to say she was amazing. Like, she really, really was amazing. And she knew how to teach. But then I found Note Perfect Project, and I'm like, wait, this is so much more fun. And again, when I took it, I was in high school, and these students that I have, they're babies. They're little children, they're beginner, some of them are in middle elementary school, some of them are a little bit younger. So I'm teaching a group of children and I cannot wait. And I'm just going to, we're going to open this box together. I've opened it before, I went through it, but I want to show you. First of all, check this out. Carry handle. So right here, that is super amazing. And magnetic top. Now, I don't know if I'm going to be teaching in one classroom, two classrooms, many classrooms. That I am not sure about. So just the fact that I can physically take this and carry it from room to room, total plus. So let's actually open it up and check out what's inside. Now, first, this was the this was the first thing that I loved. Not only is this whiteboard dry erase, look at it. It is magnetic. So, in the beginning, when you teach the children, you can actually use the, which it does come with magnets, which is another plus. Use these and have the children, well, I like to start with G, but have the children guess what note it is. You know, oh, that's the G, and then they'll write it on the bottom. So you can actually, you know, challenge your students, and when they get higher, you know, you can, just go in between, you know, sorry, that should go there. But you can actually really challenge your students and actually make small scales and stuff here. So that is amazing. One thing I want to point out is that the flute is played in treble clef and not bass clef. So for our purpose right now, I will not be teaching this. But I do think it's important if they choose to play piano or if they have access to piano at home. This is something I may consider. But for me, I know treble clef. I don't know bass clef, but check this out. On the bottom of the board, this is actually my all-time favorite. I'm not sure if I'm going to hang it up, though, in the classroom yet, because, again, I don't know if I'm in one place or mobile, but if I'm in one place, look at this. The children can actually see the notes, and as they learn the music, they can actually see which notes they could play on the flute and which notes they can't play on the flute, and they can, you know, increase their skills. There are no flats or sharps here, but that's just a minor thing. This looks dry erase, you know, write it in if a child needs it or leave it out, you know, it's cool. But like I said, what if a child has a piano at home? I have no problem sitting down with them because this right over here helps me see what I need to see. So that is amazing. But that's not all in this set. Let's keep going. Now, this is great because I like to teach through hearing. So for example, I actually start with a quarter note, and so I'd have the children bang on the desk. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So they can actually hear the notes and they would shout out by the fourth one. And we start off and, look at that. They have little time measures, but that'll come for later. But either way, you can actually use this kind of like to flip the cards over and have the children, you know, read the notes and, or as I do, bang the notes out. Or this is another really fun activity. Look at this. Let's get our board back. And you can actually dedicate one to treble clef, one to bass clef, depending on, you know, what instrument you're teaching them. But you can actually put it on, say, okay, hang it up on the wall, and then the students can actually call out. Well, I would actually stick with, rest. We can add a rest if we need to. Oopsie. You can add a rest. I'm looking for, there we go. And you can actually have the students call out the notes, or if you're working one-on-one, they can write it on the bottom. Or another fun activity is if you have, again, a group of students who are first learning to play, and let's say one child is struggling and a lot of children already know the material, then you can just leave it on the board and have them, you know, write it on their papers what they think, and, you know, go around the classroom and kind of have the students see if they got the notes correct. Because if, you know, three students labeled it correctly, then you know it's correct. But if they didn't, well, then, you know, they made a mistake. Well, they'll figure out for themselves they made a mistake and what is the mistake. So these I love, and again, you know, comes in two different colors, so you can designate if you're doing, you know, different skills, different levels. And that's really another fun activity you could do. Here we go. You know, just kind of, you could make it harder for them if you'd like, especially for the flute to play, you know, some of the faster notes. That is definitely not something most children do in the beginning, but you never know. You never know if you're going to have a gifted child in your group or not. So the fact that this set comes with everything is totally cool. And speaking about everything, I just want to show you. It comes with an eraser and a dry erase marker. Expo brand name. So this right here is totally cool. Now, one thing I love, these two boxes here, I think they're really challenging, and I'm going to show you. This is for the flute. I'm going to show you how one box is for level one and one box is for level two. So check this out. So first, the read notes at a glance is, again, you have the students, you know, what note is that? And they have to tell it to you what notes they see. And like I do, I like to have them, you know, bang and count it out. So that's really fun. So this is really simple. And what you could do is, this is a really fun game, is like give children like three or four notes. Well, of course, I would take out the bass clef, but, you know, just for my instrument purposes. But you can give students the different notes and give each student three notes and pair them up. And then, you know, like charades, they would actually have to, I would put a metronome in the background, and the children would actually have to bang out the notes. Is it for this, you know, you would just do quarter, half, eighth, whatever it is. Obviously, they can't necessarily bang to the different ones, but, you know, this is just a quick quiz to see how long for the whole note. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, or they could bang 1, 2, 1, 2, and then maybe they can do the letter sound. And so, you know, you're really quizzing the children and you're getting them to think outside the box. Like, I know a G is maybe a G, and they would go G, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever the case is, but to kind of take music and acting, because music is really, you know, another part of the soul. So to combine the two is just, it's just great. And even though I do teach the flute, maybe the bass clef would just be fun to play. Or you can just, you know, have the students take turns flipping them over and going around the class and screaming out what they see on these cards. So that is definitely a huge, huge plus. And I'm really excited to have these cards because I could see group games, individual games. It's just amazing. Now this one, this is for the more advanced students, and this one I am so excited about this set. In the flute, obviously it's a, you know, you can only play one note at a time. So what I would do is actually ask the children, which notes do you play? You always play the top note. So when they tell me which note they see, they have to, you know, tell me which note we play. It's like the G, and this actually confuses them. And I love confusing kids. I know that sounds terrible. But I love giving them an extra challenge. And what I like about this is that they're all whole notes. So it's really easy for them to stick with the whole notes. But at the same time, you're giving them two things to focus on. But as a flute player, you only focus on one thing. So this is great if you're like teaching, you know, in the future. Of course, not now. But, you know, I have a lot of sheet music that is written for piano. And so when I read it, I know to focus on the notes that are usually on top or the notes that are written for the singer. Now, a beginner child won't necessarily know what to focus on. So this is just a really, really fun idea. And again, if you have a child who finishes work early or a group of children, give them four of these cards and have them write it. Oops, sorry. I would actually have them. Sorry about that. Here's a really fun. Okay, let me clear the board. Here's a really fun challenge. I would actually put, you know, four of these, you know, with the magnets attached to here, and the children would write the notes they see here, and then they would have to map it out, and just for fun, like, have to play it, or whatever the case is. But this is just another fun way to kind of challenge the kids' minds once they become more familiar with the flute and how to read sheet music. So I just want to go through this, because this was a lot of information. So you have here, in this set, you have the whiteboard. The whiteboard is great, because, you know, in the beginning, you just write the notes that they see, so they're getting used to how the notes look on. Let me just show you. Let's take out the dry erase marker. Yeah, sorry. They actually, you know, you put the notes in. Is it a whole? Is it a half? Whatever the case is. And the children get to play it. This is also fun if you just want the children to do a practice. You know, it could be a group practice or individual practice. But just to kind of see it. And also the kids should see the music and actually have to write it themselves. Because, you know, this is all... That was a little funny one. This is all new to them. So the feel, the touch of the music. And if you want them to kind of write down the music. Well, I love these lines here because then you put three different notes here and the children have to write it down. So this is great for interactive time. Then you have the two different decks of cards. You have the first one is to get them familiar with what they see. You know, the different music notes that they see. And this one for the flute player is just good to kind of get them to play, you know, the single out what they play versus what they don't play. And for piano, well, it's just a fun challenge to have to play more than one hand at a time, which this set generally offers one hand. So I would say, one note, double notes challenge. And I just love a challenge for the kids. So I'm really excited about that. And again, here we have all of these different, you know, music notes. For me, I could just, you know, put it on the board magnetically with the magnets that could also be used to represent the music. This could be used to represent the music notes, or you can hang these up and have the children kind of guess or play what they see. Or this is actually a lot of fun. Here's another thing I just thought of. Mix these up really well and just take out three randomly and have the children play what they see on the board. Yeah, well, that would have to come out. But you get the drift, you know. Well, that's harder for the flute. But either way, let them play what they see on the board so they're kind of used to, you know, taking the music and, to make it a step further, actually write separate cards of G, A, B, C, you know, of all the notes. And then they have to, G quarter note, G eighth note, G 16th note. And then they really are forced to kind of like play music by sight. I mean, just as I see this, what's coming to my mind is just, it's amazing. We are going to have an amazing year. So what can I say? I would totally, if you're a music teacher, I would highly recommend this. And if you're not a music teacher, you could totally learn music with this book. The one thing I would recommend, just all you have to need, you know, to learn is the notes, the basic notes to get yourself started. And the rest will just come through practice. The key is practice, and this set really gives you everything to practice with, everything to teach with. Look at this. Look at all these tools. You know, you can, we got rests in here. So that's fun. Stops. And look here. There's a little bit. Oops. This I like because this actually shows, I like this. This is very much Montessori based, is that look at this. It shows the children the size of the notes. So this is definitely going to come in handy in the beginning. Look at that. You know, longer, shorter. This is definitely, what can I say? I would totally recommend it. You have your treble clef. One could be dedicated to treble. One could be dedicated to bass clef. If you're like me teaching the flute, well, guess what? You know, challenge the kids. Have them come up with their own thing, you know? And this set really comes with all the tools you need. I mean, look at that. This can also be, added as more music notes. So the amount of information, you could actually put this in as a stop if you want, like to skip that one. You know, why not throw in an added challenge? So I would definitely recommend this again. If you have no music information, this set makes it easy to kind of play along with your children. If you do have music, you know, as a background and you're looking to take it to a higher level, or like me, you're going to teach a class and you need something portable, you need something that really offers everything, this box offers everything. Look at that. You know, children can write it. This is also fun. G, and they could erase it. A, B. You know, they could actually erase it and kind of interact with this whiteboard. And the best thing is that this is magnetic. I love anything magnetic, so you can make your own materials to use here. You could use what they provided. And since this set provides more or less everything you need, there's no need to get anything else. So definitely recommend it. One more quick overview. Here we go. You have the magnets, spot for the marker, you know, different music notes, two games, an eraser, and just fun. So I would highly recommend this. And I want to know if any of you guys have the set at home. Let me know what you think. And let's not forget this. This is great because for myself, I can play treble clef and I know how to read it. But again, if a child goes, you know, I have a piano at home, can you help me out? Well, just because I'm a flute teacher does not mean I cannot teach them the bass clef as well. So this set has everything you need. And if your child is struggling, just give them this quick glance. You know, perfect tool. Totally recommend it. You know, feel free to subscribe to my channel. I'm here for my kids, for your kids, for the kids in my play-based education program. If you have taught music before, let me know what you think or some of the tricks that you use in your classroom, because together, that's how we educate children. Thank you so much for watching. Happy playing.